What's up, guys? Getting ready to start another carpet repair. I'm gonna have to explain to you what's going on here, and it doesn't look like it's gonna go really easy. So let me turn the camera around and I'll explain the one part that I'm gonna be able to do. Then I'm gonna have to start over on a separate part. Originally I cut everything to fit and then put the tape under it, and then I seam it all in and basically in steps. This one's gonna go different here. All right, I thought I was recording, so I'm gonna do all this over again here. I cut into the carpet and it started falling apart. So this piece, I'm going to have to cut out larger and around all of this here to get into some carpet that I can hopefully patch into. Over here looks like it's probably better. Over there, it's very questionable. I'll be adding a lot of hot glue underneath the tape on both sides here to try to prevent it from delaminating and falling into two pieces. Over here, what's going on is basically I added the hot glue underneath all of this already because it's very questionable. So I'm gonna pull this piece out here and I'm gonna patch this guy in. And then when I'm done with that, I'm gonna go over here and I'm going to cut this guy back to probably about here and then probably about right there and a little bit bigger around both sides. And everything will get hot glue under the tape before I heat melt it together on this. So this is not turning out to be your textbook repair after all. Rather difficult. All right, I had to actually stretch all of this together for some reason, I don't know. I guess when I cut up the carpet, maybe it pulled back or something. I'm not exactly sure. So I had to take the seam stretchers and pull it together and then stay nail it to hold my seam together close enough to where I needed it to seam it together. So if I ever get done with this right here, then get to recut another one. And I've been thinking about this one. I think I'm gonna actually probably maybe take a piece that'll go probably all the way across both, more than likely. But we'll see. But I don't wanna risk cutting one more time and having it fall apart on me. I want to reach out far enough that I know it won't do that. So we'll have to see when I get here. All right, got this guy back together now. It's turned out all right. It's a big difference in the way the fibers look. This is obviously brand new, and this is extreme wear. Now this is what I've got to work with here. So I need to oversize it. I just don't know exactly how big yet. Thinking about going wall to wall with it. I wish this wall would come out farther and I could reach all the way across. I've already checked and there's a Z-bar under there, which I hate. But looks like I'm gonna have to mess with that. So the repair will be larger, but the seam won't necessarily be larger. It'll be one across there and one across here and probably bring it back a little bit. Just gotta hope that when you cut through here, because the carpet is taking on this funny look to it due to wear. I guess the dog digs at it or sleeps here or something, I don't know. But it's got a different look than you'll see anywhere. So I don't know exactly what's going on. Maybe they had it covered or something, I don't know. Anyway, I just gotta hope that it doesn't fall apart whenever I cut through it again. It's got, yeah, you can see there's issues even out here. Right there. So I don't know what I'm going to encounter the next time I cut into it. Anyway, we'll see where I'm at in a minute. All right, here I am downstairs. What I'm basically looking for is a about 97 by 50. And luckily it's a Frise, and it's very forgiving as far as carpet direction is concerned. So I'm gonna cut a piece out of this. It's 97 by 50. And luckily there's not too many wrinkles in it, because all of those wrinkles, that's a problem sometimes. After you get through putting in a piece that's large, then sometimes you have to stretch it on top of all everything else that you've done. So I don't know what the good title for this video is. When carpet repairs grow, maybe. I don't know, but getting out beyond all of that damage, I'm just gonna get basically as far as I can get and deal with it that way. That way I feel almost certain the next time I cut into it, it's not gonna try to fall apart underneath me. So I'm gonna do some measuring here. See what I got to work with. All right, what you're looking at here is basically about 100 by 60. It's always better to have more than you need. That way you can cut some off. Well, easier to cut it off than it is to try to splice it on. That's what I always say. So anyway, I'm gonna take this guy upstairs now and kind of start laying it out and over the areas and cutting and trying to get the rest of my plan together as to where this guy is going to be trimmed to fit and where all the cuts are going to be made, and hope to God when I cut through the carpet that I don't find delamination more. So everybody out there in YouTube land, keep your fingers crossed and hoping for the best here. Luckily, all repairs don't go like this, but between last night and then today, man, I've had repairs go a whole lot smoother than this for sure. All right, this is bigger than you'd imagine. It goes to right here, and then I just let it go ahead and go to right here. That's in good shape over there, so I'm gonna cut through that. And right there, I think it appears to be in decent shape. So I'm getting out basically beyond, I've got it held in place with four nails throughout. I can't even see the ones over there, but the four nails holding this guy together, holding it down while I made these cuts, and that's the pieces I cut off it and stuff. It was that large. I mean, it, you know, went through the doorway and it folded and went down over there. So brought a large piece up here. So the repair is large, but the seaming compared to the repair is not that huge. So I'm gonna go ahead and make my cuts and take that piece out of there. What I may do is just cut this guy here and then take a section of it out under there and then seam this guy together and then pick this whole section up and bring it back and take the other one out, you know, from underneath there. That might be the way I do it. I don't know. I like to, when I'm this large, secure them somewhere before I pull the piece out underneath it. So I can't guarantee that's what's gonna happen, but I believe that's what I'm gonna do here right now. So I'm gonna cut some more carpet here, lay out some tape and do a little seaming, and hope to God I don't cut into carpet that falls apart again. So here we go. All right, this guy here is just by seamed in. So the piece is still underneath there. So I'm gonna basically kind of flatten all of this out here and make a cut under here and then I guess pull this out from underneath it. That's just, I don't know, the way I do things. I don't know if I could do that, but I don't know. I'm trying to think my way through this and decide if I'm shooting myself in the foot before I make these decisions here. Anyway, because it's the last job on Saturday, so I'm trying to minimize the pain. My back is pretty sore right now as it is. So trying to ration out my footsteps and getting up and down just a little if I can. So anyway, I'm gonna finish this guy first here, and then I'm take everything out of my way here and decide what I'm gonna do next. I think it'll be make a cut and take that piece out, most likely. That'll be what I do. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do a little re-stretching to make all this work here. So we're good though. I'm feeling it's not, doesn't look like it's gonna fall apart over there, so I think I'm good. I'm getting some coverage here, so. All right, that's where I'm at right now. I'll check back in a bit. All right, we're all seamed in. So what I'm gonna do now is I brought the power stretcher up. I'm gonna tuck and cut first, and then see where I need to do some power stretching. It's gonna be somewhere in here. It's gonna need some power stretching. I'm thinking probably from like basically across this way, and then maybe a little bit that way. It'll probably take a little bit of power stretching to get all of it where I want it, where I feel like it won't wrinkle up here. But first thing is to kick and tuck, cut, and then take a quick look at it and see where else I can improve it. So, here we go. All right. Apparently, snorted some dust up my nose or something, about choked to death here. But anyway, we're done here. I'm just gonna pick up my tools and do some vacuuming here. Quite a little bit of cleanup to do. I'm gonna go ahead and include the vacuuming on this video here. So basically, this section of the hall was put in, and then the repair right here. All right, I'll be back to vacuum it, and then we'll close out the video. Thank you. don't know what, I choked me something on the floor here. I inhaled some kind of carpet fiber or dust or something, so I feel kind of poorly now. Anyway, I appreciate you watching the video. I'm gonna go home and upload this, and I'll see you next week. Thanks for watching, God bless.